In this video, we will see how we can quickly create intents with training phrases and update those directly in Google Dialogflow CX agent. This is Google Dialogflow CX console. Let's go into our project, Dialogflow CX. And this is the agent list. Let's select telephony integration agent. These are the existing intents. There are 11 of those. So intents basically categorize an end user's intention for one conversation turn. And training phrases are example phrases for what end users might type or say, known as end user input. To create an intent, we click here and add display name. Let's say give bill payment, and we need to add training phrases one by one. I want to pay my bill, and let's save this intent. So as per Google's recommendation, we need to provide at least 10 to 20 training phrases per intent. I have added one phrase for now. So another way to create intent is to upload CSV file with the list of training phrases. So you can select the file and upload, and your intent will be created. So what if we could just generate all training phrases for a given intent and create it in Dialogflow CX with just a couple of clicks? This is an interface where we give the intent in the text box, generate training phrases, and upload those in Dialogflow CX. Generative AI is the force behind generating training phrases. We have used OpenAI's GPT-3 completions API for generative AI and Google's createIntent API for creating intent in the Dialogflow CX agent with these training phrases. Let's quickly see it in action. First, provide the intent name. Let's provide forgot password. And then click generate button. It's generating phrases right now. We will see those soon on the screen. So there you go, these phrases are ready now. These look good to me. So I'm going to create the intent in my agent now by just clicking this button. So it's created successfully. And let's go back and check Dialogflow CX if this intent was created. So awesome. So our new intent is created here, and these are the training phrases generated by GPT-3 API. That was cool, huh? So how did we do this? So details will be in the next video. Until then, bye-bye.